Good afternoon, everybody. Because my English is very bad, I have to please my friend Yang help me translation. Sorry.
I'm the first one to be in the U.S. and the first one to be in the GOED conference.
我想呢，用一点时间先做一个简单的自我介绍。
I want to do self-introduction.
我的中文名字叫王大宏。My
name is Wang Dahong.
我多说几句啊，那个我的工作呢是在中国保健协会。 负责市场研究和行业管理。
He's working in the China Healthcare Association, who is responsible for marketing research and regulatory control.
我非常热爱保健食品这个行业，我在这个行业里边呢，已经工作了20年。
I've been working for this healthcare industry for 20 years.
非常巧合的是，20年之前我进入这个行业的时候。 就是从做鱼油产品开始的。
Actually, I started in the, I entered the healthcare industry by making fish oil product.
当时我们看到，对不起，sorry。OK，当时我们看到有一本书叫《吃鱼见脑》，一个日本专家写的。那么我们买到这本书以后，发现这是一个巨大的商机，中国还没有这样的产品，然后我们就开始研发，做这个产品。
I read a book made by written by a Japanese about the fish oil is good for brain. So I found it's a good product. So we start to research and develop the product in China.
我们也是在中国第一个把 omega 3作为保健食品的一个原料进行开发的。
We were the first one to develop omega 3 into a health supplement in China.
当时呢，我们这个过程比较艰苦啊，是从中国的海边买了那些带有臭味的鱼油，自己回来进行精制。
It was a very difficult time when we started fish oil because we bought very rancid crude oil from the local market.
我们的困难是呢，就是很难把它的这个 DHEPA 的含量给它提高，另外呢，那个腥味。
It was very rancid, so these smelly, it's very strong smell, so very difficult to concentrate the omega-3, and also very difficult to do odorization.
So we made
microcapsulation to cut the smell.
在20年之前呢，我们在中国也打了很多的广告去宣传 omega-3 可以健脑，那现在看呢，它的科学依据呢。 似乎还不是特别充分。
So we did a lot of commercial advertising to of omega 3, which is good for brain, but until today, so still we need a more strong scientific support.
后来我们很幸运碰到了那个杨先生，他当时呢向我们推荐说在国外其实鱼油精制的这个市场呢，这个技术已经很成熟，那么他当时推荐给我们的产品，我记得是荷兰的。 Smith, 他的那个鱼油，我们后来用的是这个鱼油。So
by luck, he met me and we introduced the fish oil, good refined fish oil from Holland.
从这以后呢，我换了很多的工作，但是呢，作为一个 omega 3的一个粉丝，一直在关注 omega 3它的技术市场的发展。I
changed my job from business to the association. But I really looked at the market development of omega 3.
感谢 GOED 呢，给我一个机会，能够到这里跟大家学习，跟大家分享。
So thanks to GOED chance for me to share the information, business information with everybody here.
在来之前呢，我们做了一个很漂亮的一个中文的 PPT， 但是今天才发现呢，它加了英文以后变成了一个草稿啊，这个很抱歉。回去以后呢。 我们会再做一个英文的，一个更成熟的 PPT 呢，再发给 GOED 跟大家再分享。
So I'm sorry that I did a Chinese version, and then we did added English version to a Chinese version, so which does not look well. So after I'm back, I will revise my presentation to send to GOED.
GOED 呢给我的这个任务是介绍一下中国保健食品市场的整体情况和 Omega 3的一些情况。 那么由于这两个市场在中国保健食品也好 ，Omega 3也好，在中国呢，很复杂。那么只能简明扼要的给大家讲一些要点。
I'm going to talking about health market and also fish omega-3 market, but which is both of them are very very complicated. If I can finish my introduction of the these two segments within 50 minutes, it's very difficult.
那咱们现在先开始介绍一下中国保健食品市场的一个整体的一个情况。
So let's see. Let's talk about the overview of development of health product in China.
二十年之前这一类产品的介绍开始，二十年之前就做过 omega-3 的健脑的这个产品。
So 20 years ago, there was an omega-3 product in China, and he was in this business.
从1996年开始，中国政府建立了保健食品管理的法规和管理的体系。
So since 1996, Chinese government set up the system of managing or supervision of the health product.
但是呢，这个体系呢，它没有能够涵盖所有的产品的品类，那所以这个体系也被行业在批评。目前呢，政府也正在改进它。
So this system is not complete to cover all the products. So now the system or the policy will say.It's being improved.
现在的情况是，能够改善健康的啊这样的保健，广义的这样的保健食品，啊，在中国的市场呢，一共有六类。
So now there is about six categories in the market.
按照它的理论来源的不同，我们把它分成两类，一类是现代科学的，一类是中国传统医学的。
So basically all these six categories based on two segments. One is a product based on the scientific research, and the second one is based on the Chinese traditional medicine.
现代科学的这一类呢，就是包括维生素、矿物质，咱们的 omega-3 属于现代科学的一类。
So like the vitamins and the minerals and omega-3, it belongs to modern segments.
另外呢，中国还有一些本土的。有些比较神秘的一些产品，那么从现代科学来讲，很难对它的机理进行解释。
There are also very functional product, which is even very very secret, but very difficult to explain to them by science.
按照它的管理来讲呢，也分两类，一类呢就是需要政府去审批啊，个案审批；第二一类呢，建立标准进行备案。
So.Talking about the management of supervision from the government, you need to register the product, and also you need to set up some standard for the product.
这是中国的产品的管理啊。那么中国的企业现在，也已经有了很多大的企业。我们统计了一下，啊，在前十名里边，啊，第十名已经超过10亿人民币。那么前十名的销售额的总和，能够占到整个行业的60%。
So now, top 10 of supplements companies in China, they have shares 60% of the total market share of the total market of health product.
在这里边呢，做的在中国做的最好的是美国的安利公司，它的销售额超过200亿人民币，然后在整个市场的份额里边占到25%。
So like Amway US, they have a 25% share of the total market.With a turnover of 20 billion RMB.
它的那个 omega-3 的产品呢是1812的一个三文鱼的一个鱼油。
His product, Amway's product is a salmon 1812.
这是中国的企业情况。那中国的产品的情况呢，大概排在前面的是这样的五类。
The lead, you know, you see the leading five product categories.
分别是第一位呢是钙，第二位是蛋白质粉，第三是多种维生素，第四是鱼油，也就是 omega-3， 第五个是卵磷脂。
Yeah, so the first one is calcium and protein, vitamin, the minerals, fish oil, and lecithin.
Omega-3 呢，这个大家看这个数据，在2007年是。人民币啊，40亿，12年呢，我们预测今年会到60亿，它 它的增长速度是8%。
So you can see the official in the total turnover of in the year of 2007 is ¥4 billion RMB. The RMB is 6.3 about US dollar. So and the year this year the turnover of official product will be ¥6 billion RMB.And the growth rate is 8%.
那么在过去五年整个行业的增长速度是12%。那么鱼油呢只有8%，为什么会低过这个平均的速度？那么实际上它的销量是在增加，但是由于价格同时在下降，所以我们这做的是零售额的一个统计。
The total growth rate of the supplement market in China is a 12% annual base.And but fish oil is only 8%. The reason is because the retail price of fish oil is getting down, but the total quantity is increased.
再介绍一下中国这个行业的这个环境，因为我们跟境外的很多国家呢，包括日本呢，都跟他们交流，他们都非常眼红我们中国的一个发展环境。
So let me talk about the environment of development and they.He used to have a meeting with the Japanese people, and they are really interested in the Japanese, in the Chinese development environment. It's good.
中国政府呢现在非常重视扶持这个行业的发展。为什么会这样？因为，中国现在，出现了这个叫慢性疾病，爆发这样的一个情况。那么中国的医疗条件又比较差，所以政府希望发展保健食品行业，作为一种对抗慢性病。发展的一种手段。
The first good environment is getting the strong support from the government. The reason is because the Chinese is in the high speed of the chronic disease. So the government wants to use the supplement to make people healthy to save the cost for medical insurance.
再一个呢，从消费者角度来讲，他们的健康呢会面临很多新的威胁，包括大家知道中国环境污染比较严重，生活节奏比较快，他们也希望寻找到一个改善健康的方法，那么都想去买保健食品。
Of course, from the from people, they also understand they also have getting the old and unhealthy a lot of and also the contamination of the air, food. They also want to buy the supplement to keep themselves fit.
那中国的经济在发展，中国的消费者呢也有钱，他们可以掏出更多的钱去买。
Yeah, since the growth of the Chinese economy, people has increased their purchasing power to buy the supplements.
那么整个中国保健食品行业呢，它的一个发展的趋势现在能看得很清楚。首先一个就是它的成长速度，在未来五年的成长速度，我们预计是20%，超过前五年的12%。
Yeah, so the increase of the supplement industry will be 20%, because in the last 5 years it was 12%.
第二一个呢，这个政府他希望扶持这个行业发展。那么在经过了过去的3年时间，一直在研究新的这个管理体系。那么我作为参与这项工作的一个行业的一个工作人员，那么也可以向大家发布一下呢，在今年。这个新的管理体系会出台。
The Chinese government has continued to support the industry and to improve by improving the regulatory. So Mr. Wang is a part of these regulatory policy making. So he can tell everybody there will be new regulatory of Chinese supplement to be issued by the end of this year.
这个新的管理体系呢，更强调管理的这种科学性，和进入的这个门槛的这个合理性。那么这个新的政策出台以后，会有更多的投资人、更多的人才进入到中国的保健食品行业。
So the new regulatory will make the door open and more make everything reasonable. So investments or talented people will join this development of the supplement.
那么在这个各方面的这个因素的影响之下呢，那么目前中国已经出现了一个。投资高度关注这个行业发展的一种情况。
So now more investments go to supplement industry.
所以在未来的五年呢，我们预计呢会有上百家上市公司出现在这个行业里边。
I expect that in the coming 5 years, there will be over 100 companies will be listed in the stock exchange market.
那我们下面介绍一下 Omega 3在中Omega 3在中国的一个情况。那么它属于保健食品行业的一部分，那么它也会像保健食品行业整体一样快速发展。
So let's talk about Omega 3. Omega 3 will be a part of the fast growth development of the old supplement.
那么我们认为呢 ，Omega 3在整体中呢，它会起到，它会比整体发展速度还要快。
So he expects that Omega 3 will be faster developed than other supplements.
为什么会这样？我想，因为最主要的是它有非常充分的科学依据，还有这么多年积累的一个消费的基础。
The reason is that because more and more scientific support and also a good consumer base.
那在中国的现在 Omega 3呢，我们研究了一下，它在六个产品类别里边是可以去应用。
So after research, we can see that the Omega 3 can be used in all six categories, which was mentioned in the first page.
啊，包括药啊，保健食品、功能食品等等。那么在这些类别里边呢？那么现在，管理的法规标准啊，它并不一定是非常完善。那么在保健食品这个门类里面，相对是最完善的。
So now you can see the omega 3 official. It can be used in the medicine, functional food, and supplements.
那么在这些类别里边呢，现在成长的速度也是不一样。那么最快的是在特殊膳食用食品这一类里面发展最快。
So you can see all these categories, omega-3, and the growth rate is different. And the fastest one is in foods for special dietary uses.
我们所说的特殊膳食用食品呢，就是说针对特殊人群啊，它发挥特殊的营养补充作用的这类产品。那么最有代表性的就是婴儿配方奶粉。
The good example is infant formula.
这个婴儿配方奶粉呢，我们做了一个统计，在过去的五年，它的成长速度在28%。
In the last 5 years, the infant formula has been grown by 28%.
好，那么 Omega 3呢，在中国未来的发展啊，我们认为有这么四个发展的一个机遇。
I think there are four opportunities for Omega 3 development in China.
首先呢，是对 Omega 3的它这个新功能的这个研究。那么现在中国政府呢允许，啊 ，Omega 3啊鱼油，它可以声称，辅助降血脂，还可以声称，改善记忆。
So now a new recognition of the function has been accepted by the government, like, you know, official Omega 3 can reduce blood lipids and can improve the memory.
但是呢。这两个声称的这个科学依据呢，在中国的研究是不充分的。那么，如果没有更充分的依据补充上去的话，很可能这两个功能也会被取消。
But because the research on these two functions is not a strongly developed research in China, so if it goes like that, that even in the end, the government will reject these two claims because there's only scientific research from the outside.
所以有雄厚的科研实力的企业，如果能够提供啊更充分的科学依据的话，那么在中国，它是有更大的竞争力的。
So if anybody can do research in China, then your products or your company can be more competitive in China.
啊，那么如果能够发现其他的功能，而且有充分的论据的话，同样的是可以提升它的竞争力。
The door is open for new functions if you can support scientific proof.
第二一个机遇呢是新的原料的来源。那么现在来自于鱼的，啊，来自于藻类的，啊，那么生物工程的都有。那么未来如果还能发现新的来源啊，比如说磷虾油，啊，那么具有这种新来源的企业会有竞争优势。
Yeah, new resources also are welcome. Now it's from fish, from algae, or from other bioengineering, but also now.He also understands there's a new product like a krill oil is coming to the market, which is will be a big future. And also, if even a new products will be is welcome.
再有呢，产品呢会出现一些新的流行趋势。如果呢能够跟上这些趋势的话，会是企业的一个企业的机遇。那么包括一些成熟的产品， 会变成快消品，那么一些功能很强的产品可以作为辅助治疗的产品。
So if you can also develop some new product form, that will be also bring you business. So like if it's a mature product, can be become in fast food, fast selling product in the market, or if some functional product can be transformed into the medicine.
还有一个趋势呢，就是食品的功能化，就是很多大家日常吃用的这些食品，他们也非常希望啊，把 omega 3添加进去，使它有功能。
Yeah, also functional food, which is also good for DHA.
前面讲的都是它的这个趋势啊和机遇，那么实际上它的发展还是有些困难的。
So I just mentioned these opportunities and developed the trend, but actually also we face a lot of challenges.
首先一个困难呢是表现在管理的方面，重要的两点呢，一个是对原料，因为原料很多，那么对于原料的标准现在建立的并不完善。
So the first one is a supervision system or a regulatory from the government side. The two things. One is a raw material standard, which is not complete.
第二个关于产品声称的管理。那么现在如果要声称功能的话，就要去做个案的这种行政许可，那么需要很长的时间，花很多的钱。
If you want to claim your function in your product, which takes a complicated process and also a lot of time.
第二一个困难呢，是因为中国发展的现在太快了，那么有很多的假冒的产品啊，这些产品呢，经常被媒体去曝光，然后影响了消费者对这类产品的信任。
And also because the market has been developed too fast, a lot of fake products also come into the market, and which will be reported by the as a food scandal.So that will also have an impact on the development of the omega-3.
再一个困难呢，就跟咱们刚才看到的录像一样，那么消费者对 omega-3 的了解是不充分的，它的来源啊，它的机理啊，它的这个还不能做到理性消费。
And also consumers have a lack of knowledge of omega-3, function, nutritional, everything.
再一个问题呢，就是。Omega 3是虽然排在按照类别分排在第四位，但是呢 ，Omega 3里边没有领袖级的产品。
Yeah, Omega 3 product is listed in the fourth place of the total supplements. But until today, no leading brand, a supplement leading brand in China, focus on the Omega 3 product.
不但没有领袖的品牌。那么也没有一个专业的这样的一个行业协会，这样的话呢，在政府制定政策、制定标准的时候，这个企业缺少一个沟通的话语权。
There is no leading brand of omega-3. There is also no some organization of GOIT in China, because then when China makes the government makes any regulatory on omega-3, there's no any people any company who can lobby or who can talk to the government.
好，那么介绍中国的情况呢，大致就是这样。那么最后总结一下，就是中国的保健食品行业，包括 omega-3 这行业，我们认为呢是到了一个快速发展的一个前奏期。
So I want to make some conclusions. Chinese supplement industry is in the high speed stage.
从中国政府的支持啊，消费者的这种。特别想买，还是企业的投资特别踊跃，都在推动它发展。
So whatever government support and investments from all over the world, and also the need, the demand from the consumers, they are pushing up the development of the supplements in China.
但是我们中国本土的企业那个科技研发的力量还不足啊，商业开发能力还不足，所以我们希望更多的境外的朋友境外的企业把好产品。科技带到中引入中国。
All the local companies, they have a weak R&D and a scientific base work. So we are really welcoming the international old company friends to come to China with their good research.
Thank you, everybody.
Thank you, everybody.